are sending email marketing, in order for it to be successful, your message needs to reach the inboxes of your subscribers. From time to time, lots of us will have deliverability problems, and our lovingly crafted email marketing may be going into your recipient's junk. In this video, we're going to explore the top reasons why this might be. After watching, you'll have everything you need to know to increase the chances of your email marketing landing in the inbox, not the junk box. Domain name not verified. If you're using third-party email marketing software to send your email marketing to your viewers, it will appear as being from you, using your company domain as the send from and reply to address, but it's actually being sent by your email marketing software. So to your recipient's mail filter, it looks like it's from one source, but it's actually from another. This can cause some mail filters to class it as spam. This is why it's really important to verify your sending domain address. Verifying your sending domain has become vital in the last few years to ensure a decent inbox placement of your marketing. Verifying your sending domain involves adding an SPF record and a DKIM signature. The purpose of this is to add a seal of authenticity. If you're an email blaster client, then we make this really easy for you by providing a quick guide with all of the required info ready for you to just cut and paste into your domain settings. Generic send from address. When sending out your email marketing, lots of us use generic addresses such as marketing app, news app, or sometimes even no reply app. Whilst it's handy to have a mailbox set up just for your email marketing, these types of mailboxes can trigger an overzealous email filter. Some mail filters are set to class anything as spam from a generic address. It's always a good idea to send any marketing from your own mailbox. For example, Jamie ad. Not only does this have a much lower chance of ending up in the junk, but marketing sent from a real person has a much better chance of engaging with your viewers. At the end of the day, people like to deal with people. Sending from your own email address helps build trust with your viewers. Spam phrases contained within the body and or subject header. When you send an email, your recipient spam filter will analyze and score both the subject header line and the body text. These spam filters will screen your text against a database of thousands of phrases that have been associated with previous spam email. Typically, these are phrases such as discount, promotion, special offer, don't miss out, or sale. It's worth giving careful consideration to both your subject header line and the body text, as these play a substantial part in whether your email will be delivered to the inbox or to junk. Now, any decent email marketing software will have an inbuilt spam checker tool. This is great because it'll identify any action that you need to take before sending any emails to ensure that your email is inbox friendly. Too many images. When your email is being scanned by your recipient's email filter, one of the other factors it's looking at is the ratio of images versus text. Spam filters can be set to penalize anything that looks like email marketing, so they'll be looking for lots of images contained within. It's always a good idea to support your images with enough text to keep the spam filters happy. Any decent email marketing software would take care of the heavy lifting for you by measuring the ratio between the two and advising you if you need to take action. As a general rule of thumb, the ideal mailer should be 80-20 text to image ratio, with 80% of your mailer being text based. That is an ideal mailer, but at a very minimum it should be at least 60% text. Lower than that and you may find that your mailer is penalized. Low engagement rates. When you send out email marketing, each send generates a record of what your viewers did with this send. This interaction is termed as engagement. If people are reading your email or clicking on any of the links contained within, then this generates a positive engagement history. Alternatively, if people are not clicking or reading on what you are sending, then this generates a negative engagement history. Your recipient's mail filter will be able to see this engagement history and will decide where to deliver your email based on this information. So if you have a history of previous low engagements, then this will increase the chances of delivery to junk. Your recipient's mail filter makes a decision that if you haven't read or engaged with previous sends, then perhaps this isn't an email that you want to receive. Positive engagement history is created by qualifying your data and split testing your mailers with different content. Taking the time to send the right email to the right people will ensure positive engagement, contributing to good inbox placement. Blocked IP address or company domain. Another piece of information that your recipient's mail filter can see is the history of the sending server of your company domain name. If spam has been previously logged as coming from either the server that your account lives on or from your own company domain, then either or both of these could be added to a blacklist. When your recipient's mail server receives an email, it will scan these blacklists looking for your server or your company domain. If either is listed, then it will be blocked or delivered to junk. So it's worth checking your data to make sure that everyone has properly opted in to receive your emails. If your recipients feel that your send is unsolicited, then they could complain to their email service provider, who in turn could add you to a blacklist. Previous spam complaints. When your recipient receives your email, if they feel that it's unsolicited and they did not ask to receive it, they can click on a button inside their browser to mark it as spam. The browser will then remember this choice and will automatically put all future emails into the junk. Now, each time a viewer does this, it's classed as a spam complaint. These spam complaints are attached to the sending domain and will follow the sender even if they switch service providers. This one really ties in with the last few points. Taking the time to qualify your data ensures that you're sending the right email to the right people. Inconsistent sends in terms of volume or timing. When sending email marketing, it's important to send consistent volumes. Your send will carry with it a history of previous activity of your sending server. Now, if a recipient's mail server suddenly receives a high volume of email from that server, is showing as having sent nothing or a very small amount traditionally, then this can trigger a spam filter. Some mail filters can see a sudden spike in sending volumes as an activity from a compromised server, perhaps indicating that it's been hacked. This is why it's a good idea to send regular volumes at fairly regular times. The other bonus is that recipients are more likely to engage positively with your send if they're expecting it at certain time intervals. Poor opt-in process followed by your data. As we've previously discussed, your sending server and company domain carry a history of previous activity and how your viewers are engaging with your send. Positive history and engagements mean that spam filters look at your send favourably. A negative history means that the filter could class your email as spam. If your recipients don't recall how they asked to receive your mailer, they can mark it as spam. So if you've used a process like a soft opt-in, where the opt-in box is pre-ticked, then this doesn't make for a decent opt-in process. Your recipients may mark your mailer as spam and unsubscribe if they feel that they didn't recall opting in. These negative engagements will increase your chances of your emails going into junk. Using purchase lists. Most issues with poor deliverability can be associated with purchase lists. As we've previously discussed, how people interact with your sends play a huge part in if your recipient's mail filter would deliver it into the junk or the inbox. With purchase lists, if your recipients didn't ask to receive your mailer, they won't know who you are and won't be expecting to receive your mailer. This alone typically prompts people into unsubscribing and reporting your send as spam. If enough people do this, then it pretty much torpedoes any future marketing that you do. Also, if you've sent to a list that you've bought, your sending volume will be inconsistent, as you'll probably be going from a small volume to a much larger volume. This, as we know, can cause deliverability issues. So as much as it's tempting to quickly acquire lots of email addresses, purchase lists can be fraught with issues. Okay, that wraps up our video on why your email might be going into your recipient's spam filter. If you follow the points enclosed, then hopefully it can start making improvements to your deliverability. I hope you found this video useful and informative, and be sure to like and subscribe or add any comments below. Thank you.